rejoicing in the house of the Lord for the celebration, dear brothers and sisters. And now we stand with Teresa and Colin on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayer as their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. And then with Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God the Father, through Christ our Lord, for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. So let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these your servants, Teresa and Colin, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. We make our prayer for Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Song of Songs. Hark, my brother, here he comes, spring across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My brother, 'tis like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind the wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My brother speaks to me. He says to me, arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. O my dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet, and you are lovely. My lover belongs to me, and I belong to him. He says to me, set me as a seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm, for stern as death is love, relentless as the nether world is devotion, its flames are a blazing fire. Deep waters cannot quench love, nor floods sweep it away. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord. I waited for this day for a long time. I'm just going to talk to the couple. You can listen in. Let's start with that first reading. Here he comes springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle. Are you serious? Are you serious? Not any wildest dreams, not even an angel. You can't even get away with that lie today. But the rest of the reading might be true. My lover belongs to me and I to me. Deep waters cannot quench love nor sweep it away. I believe that both of you are deeply in love, and I believe that even more so after we're in the sacristy together. Because Colin said to me and to all of us there, I'm marrying Teresa for love, not for brains. And for Teresa, you have to understand, Colin is basically all about himself. So you have a lot to put up with in so many ways. Yeah. But today you begin your marriage in this church with all these people here who are important. They come as witnesses to the fact that your marriage is now a sacred community. When you marry a church, you do so because your marriage becomes a manifestation of God's presence in our world and his love for you, that he loves you unconditionally. And I know that God blesses your life together and that hopefully his love will strengthen that bond and that friendship. The poet George Sand once said, there's only one happiness in life, and that is to love and to be loved. And that's certainly God is love. And his love we share as his sons and daughters, the love we share by the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, as we look forward to the Passion next week. It's a love we're called to model. And the love you share not only with one another, but with your family and your friends who are here, is essential to a successful marriage. The reading from Corinthians that you chose says, if I have all the faith to move mountains, but am without love, I am nothing. And I'm sorry, but I will never look at that reading the same again, because every time I think of the clanging gong, I think of you. And yet there's so much under there, so much under that speaks to that reading about love being patient and kind. Love means always being concerned for the other. Putting the other first, trusting the other.
being patient with one another. And the love you two share makes the two of you one, as the reading, as the gospel said, that you're one in God. Dr. James Dobson once said, you don't marry the person you think you can live with, you marry only the individual you think you can not live without. And hopefully you're getting married in this church because you know that you can't live without one another. And what will make a difference in your lives will be remembering what got you to today. The promise and commitment that you'll make in a few minutes to one another. When you say, I take you to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. And so when difficulties come your way, and they will, that will be the time for you to call your vows you make to one another and then renew them. And I think many couples forget that part of their vows that speaks about the bad times and the sickness. They forget the vow of love and honor for life, and so they run when things don't go the way they expected. And breaking your vows means broken lives. And not only one, but all these people who love you so much and who depend upon you, because when your marriage comes to an end, people get caught in the middle. If you want to keep your vows, if you want to honor and love one another, then you need to keep God in your marriage. He promises you his love, his care, his support. So turn to him and let him nourish. Put your cares on his shoulders, for his yoke is easy and his burden is light. Turn to him in those difficult times, but also in those happy times, those good times. We tend sometimes to turn to God when things are not going well. But keep him in your lives when things are going well. If anything happens in you in any way, say harsh words or words you already mean. When things go wrong in your relationship, turn to God first and then seek each other's forgiveness. And once you've forgiven, make sure you forget so that you're not constantly bringing up old hurts and holding the other one hostage. There's no sin we can commit that cannot be forgiven if we have faith in one another and in God. And I'm sure you learn that the tools of a good marriage are respect, the ability to listen, and the desire to understand one another. But the greatest tool is prayer, because prayer joins us with God. God brought you two together, and he has known this day was going to happen from all eternity. What a comforting thought that is. That before you were even born, God knew you would come to this day. In this church in front of these people. God blesses this union, and so do we. We bless your love, we ask God to bless you. We pray that you continue to grow in your commitment. And we thank God for the precious gift you are to him, and to all of us who love you two so much. As one of the many Irish
presence of the church's minister and the community. Your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Colin and Teresa, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
We do.
You have to speak for yourself.
I do.
You can't presume that she did.
I never do.
I do.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Shall I repeat after me? I, Colin, take you, Teresa, to be my wife.
I, Colin, take you, Teresa, to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Teresa, take you, Colin, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church, and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put aside. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other, the sign of love and fidelity. As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Teresa and our brother Colin. Let us commend them to the Lord.
Response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church and its leaders, may their commitment to the gospel lead us to deepen our faith and trust in God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world and its leaders, may their decisions be guided with the principle that all people should be treated with the dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country and those who defend it, may our men and women who serve in the armed forces and police department be kept safe from all harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, depressed, homeless, or suffering in some way, may they be strengthened by God's love and aided by friends and family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Teresa's mother, Candace, and for our grandparents, Stephen and Jane Serino, Earl and Jean Michaels, Tom and Peggy Burke, and Jack and Vera Irwin, may they know the peace and fullness of eternal life with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our guests gathered here with us today, may they enjoy the warm company of family and friends and have safe travels on their journey home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Teresa and Colin, may they live long, blessed lives together. May their love grow stronger each and every day. And may they build a family rooted in faith and unconditional love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, Colin and Teresa, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those who have joined, and no harm come to those who have filled with your blessing. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two, but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. God, look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, Teresa. And let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Colin, entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children. And grant that, reclining at last, reaching at last the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
to be one.